Hello traders, I continue now with the market watch that we have on the left side of MetaTrader. Now normally when you install the MetaTrader, you will not see all of the assets provided by the broker. So what you need to do is you need to right click on any of the assets and go to show all. And you can see how many more assets were added to the market watch. Now, normally we have the currencies on the top, then below we have some indexes, and then we have some stocks or commodities, and with some of the brokers we have the cryptocurrencies, and really depends what broker you have selected. So you can see at the end here we have the oil, the Brent crude oil, and we have the Bitcoin on the bottom. And as you see, the different categories of assets are with different colors, so this way it is easier for the trader to look for any of the assets. And if you're looking for any asset, what you can do is you can use your keyboard. So for example, if I am looking for the pound New Zealand, let's say, I will click on G and I will go to pound yen, pound dollar. If I click one more time, pound Aussie, and then it goes to pound New Zealand. So it will start showing all the currencies starting with the pound, okay, starting with the G. Now let's say I am looking for the gold and I will press the X and it goes to the silver first, and then you can see the next one is the gold. So you can use your keyboard, just press the first letter of the asset you are looking for and it will start jumping to all assets starting with this letter, so it will be easier for you to find it. Now here normally we have three columns. You see on the left I have the symbol, then I have the bid, and then I have the ask price. Now for the very newbie traders here, I will mention that we have two prices because we buy on the ask price and we sell on the bid price. So for example, if I take euro dollar, the one I have over the chart, you can see I have 114.628 and then I have 114.6345. It's changing, right? So the ask price, if you look carefully, it is bigger than the bid price all the time, which means that I'm having the difference here between these two, and this difference is called spread. So basically this is what our broker benefits, okay? It benefits the spread, meaning that we will buy on the more expensive price, on the ask price, and we will close the position or we will sell it back on the bid price, okay? So it's not like I am paying the spread to the broker. Normally every trader says, I pay the spread, we pay the spread, how much spread we pay. And we can take it as a true because we buy on the more expensive price and we sell on the cheaper price, but it's not an actual payment that we do for the transaction, okay? It's not a fee that we pay. It is just we buy on the more expensive price and we sell on the cheaper price, and this is actually the best way that you can remember it, okay? And you can see the spread by right click one more time and I will go to spread. So it will appear as a fourth column right here. And normally with the euro dollar we have one of the cheapest spreads, and as you can see for the others it is a bit more, it's changing. Actually we have small spread for the major currencies. These are the euro dollar, the Aussie, Aussie stands for Australian dollar, versus the American dollar, which is kind of slang, the Aussie, okay? And then we have pound dollar, the slang here is cable, by the way. And then we have, what we have below is dollar Swiss. Well, dollar Swiss, it's a kind of doubt nowadays, is it a major currency after it was released from the euro? Anyway, it was considered before that to be a major currency, and the dollar yen as well is a major currency. And with these currencies, we have this smaller spread with some of the cross pairs. We call them cross pairs, the ones that are not with the American dollar, such as pound Aussie or euro New Zealand. We call them cross pairs, and there the spread is just a little bit higher. Now it is up to you if you want to keep the spread column, but personally I prefer to keep it. Okay, it is good to monitor all the time how much is the spread with the broker, because what happens normally is people open an account with a broker, they choose a broker with a small spread, and they take it that the spread will be small all the time. But of course the brokers change that and they can change it at any time. Especially what happened with the Bitcoin during this time last year, it was really crazy market with the Bitcoin, so the spreads were floating from $10 up to $200, and with some of the brokers the spreads were really really high, and many people were losing just because they didn't notice what a spread the broker has selected to place, and it was really really hard to trade on such a high spread. But this was like an exceptional case. Normally with the currency pairs the spread is in a small range. For example, for the major pairs is somewhere between 2-3 points up to 10 points or 1 pip, okay? And with the cross pairs is between 10 to 20, and of course with some is above 20 points or 2 pips. Okay, now to make it clear as well for the very newbie traders here, what is the pip and the point? The pip, this is the fourth digit that we have with the 5-digit broker. Okay, so this is 5-digit broker. As you see, after the decimal comma, where is the euro dollar right here? After the decimal comma, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And with very simple words, the fourth one is the pip and the last one is the point. And obviously 10 points equals to 1 pip. So here we can say that the price is 114.68 pips, okay? It's 68 pips, the third and the fourth one. And the last one is the point. So it's 68 pips and 9 points or 8 points because it's changing. And with the regulated brokers, we need to have in mind that with the major currencies, we definitely need to have spread below 1 pip. Okay, so it should be in points. For me, having a broker with spreads of points and not in pips is good enough. It means the broker has low spreads, and of course it's very important to have a low spread. Okay, I hope I made it very clear here with these simple explanations. I really don't like theory, and you will not see slides in my courses where I will explain long theory. I prefer to explain it very practically, showing it over the chart. And one last thing here about the market watch, if I right click on it, I will go to specification. Okay, this is where I see the specification of the assets. So for this broker, for the euro dollar, what we have floating spread. What you see, the spread is not fixed, but it's changing all the time. Normally it depends on the volatility of the market. When there is some volatility, some important news on the market, you will see the spread a little bit higher. And then when the market is calm, you will see it on the regular levels. And this is what we call floating spread. Now digits, we have 5 because this is 5-digit broker. And nowadays actually it's very hard to find 4-digit broker anymore. Most of them are with 5 digits. And then we have contract size 100,000. This means that one lot equals to 100,000. If I buy one lot of euro dollar, this is the quantity that we can buy. We are buying actually 100,000 euro versus the American dollar. Okay, the margin currency here is in euro, the first one that we have in the pair, and below we have what is the margin percentage, and I will explain about the margin later on and where you see it on the MetaTrader. And what we have below is the minimal volume of 0.01, which will actually equal to 1,000 of a contract size, okay? 0.01 is like we buy 1,000 euro versus the dollar. The maximal volume here is 1,000 and a volume step is 0.1. Here we have swap long and swap short. Now keep in mind that here as well, the brokers change the swap with the time. And for the moment, we have negative of 13.125. And then we have swap short of positive 6075. Which means that if I'm having a long position, okay, if I buy the euro dollar and I keep this position overnight, it will charge me with a swap, okay? A negative swap. The swap is the cost that we pay to the broker to hold our position overnight. And swap short is if we have a sell position, a short position. So when we buy, we say it's a long position. When we sell, we say it's a short position. Now, having a short position in this case will bring us some benefit of having positive swap, okay? If I keep the trade overnight, it will bring me this positive swap. Now, some of the brokers calculate it as percentage. You can see here, this is in points, okay? And we have below the session hours when the market is opened for this broker. All right, guys, now very important here as to monitor what is the time on your broker. Now, with me personally being in Bulgaria, I am having 2 hours difference for this broker, as this broker is having the UK time or the GMT time, and it shows 2 p.m. and 47 minutes. My local time now is 4 p.m. and 47 minutes. So when you install the MetaTrader, have a look at the hour just in front of the market watch. And it is very important because the hour sometimes is very, very important for some strategies that you might have. Okay, guys, this is about the market watch. Nothing really complicated here. We have the assets, we have the bid and the ask price, and we have the spread as well. These are the most important things that you need to know about the market watch in MetaTrader. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next lecture. Cheers.